Okay, what we have seen in last session, okay, software is a collection of programs. Program is collection of functions. Functions collection of statements. Statement is collection of words, and word is collection of characters. Correct. And if you have seen the entire journey, okay, characters are three types: format character, escape character, and ASCII characters. Then words are of two types: reserved words and your user-defined words. Then we have seen sentence has got different types, not types I'll say, but every sentence has got different syntax. Syntax means what, by the way? Rule of writing. If somebody doesn't know what is syntax, syntax means how we should write it. That's called syntax, okay, in technical words. And then we have seen there are two types of functions. Now, what we need to do? We need to write a program to accept two numbers from user and display their addition. Okay. Now I'll give you 2 minutes. In your notebook, try to write this program. काय करायचंय? यूजर कडे तुम्हाला दोन नंबर ऍक्सेप्ट करायचेत आणि त्याचे ऍडिशन डिस्प्ले करायचे. अँड मोमेंट यू आर डन, रेज योर हँड्स. इट्स गुड टू सी दॅट हाफ ऑफ द क्लास हॅज ट्राईड समथिंग. नाउ आय डिड नॉट एक्सपेक्ट फ्रॉम यू टू कम्प्लीट द प्रोग्राम, ओके, बिकॉज आय नो फॉर रायटिंग दिस प्रोग्राम द थिंग्स रिक्वायर्ड आय हॅव्हन्ट टॉट यू येट. तुम्हाला ज्या गोष्टी लागणार आहेत प्रोग्राम लिहिण्यासाठी ते अजून तुम्ही शिकवले नाही आहे सगळ्या. तर तुम्हाला हा प्रोग्राम नाही आला तर टेन्शन घेऊ नका. दोज हू अटेंडेड कॉलेज लेक्चर्स, प्रॉब्ली युअर कॉलेजेस हॅव गॉन अहेड, दे ऑलरेडी टॉट यू, सो यू मे बी नोईंग थिंग्स. इट्स ओके, इट्स गुड, ओके. पण ज्यांना प्रोग्राम नाही आला, दोज हू कुडंट राईट इट, इट्स ॲब्सोल्युटली फाईन, डोंट वरी अबाउट इट. वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न नाउ, दॅट्स फाईन. थँक्यू. लोअर हँड्स गाईज. नाउ लेट्स अंडरस्टँड फ्यू थिंग्स टू राईट दिस कोड. If you want to write C program, you'll have to write a function, correct? Which function you must write if you want to write C program? It's a main function. So how to write main function? Function name is main, after that round brackets, and then the code is written inside main function, inside curly brackets. आपण या ब्रॅकेटच्या आतमध्ये कोड लिहितो. As this function will not return anything, if you write statement like return 1, return 0, then that return 1 or 0 is an integer, so we will have written data type int here. But because we are not writing return statement, we are writing here void. Void manje ya function madna apan kahi return karat nahi hot, that's why we are writing here void. All right, so that's a blank main function. Now what we want to do, we want to accept two number from user. Correct. So what we can do? We can just tell user enter two numbers. So to tell user something, we have to tell user, we use printf. आपल्या युजर शी जे काय बोलायचंय तर बोलायला प्रिंट एफ वापरतात. बिकॉज वेन युअर प्रोग्राम विल प्रिंट इट ऑन द स्क्रीन, यूजर विल रीड इट. द क्वेश्चन इज हाऊ टू ऍक्सेप्ट टू नंबर. प्रिंट एफ फक्त मेसेज प्रिंट होईल ना. टू ऍक्सेप्ट टू नंबर्स वी रिक्वायर अनदर फंक्शन अँड दॅट इज स्कॅन एफ. काय स्कॅन एफ नावाचं फंक्शन आहे ज्याने आपल्याला युजरकडनं इनपुट घेता येतो. ओके, व्हेन आय राईट स्कॅन एफ, यू आर गोइंग टू स्कॅन द इनपुट इन सम फॉर्मॅट. सो व्हॉट इज द फॉर्मॅट? यू वॉन्ट टू ऍक्सेप्ट टू नंबर्स. द नंबर्स आय एम अज्युमिंग हियर आर डेसिमल नंबर्स, नॉट ऑक्टल, नॉट हेक्साडेसिमल नंबर. सो आय एम अज्युमिंग हियर डेसिमल नंबर्स. नाउ इफ डेसिमल नंबर इज देयर, व्हॉट इज द फॉर्मॅट कॅरेक्टर यूज? परसेंट डी. मग एका नंबरला एक परसेंट डी. So for two numbers, if I write 1% D for one decimal number, I will write use two decimal numbers. So 2% is. Now this is what is called as format string, which we have to enclose in double quotes. I repeat in Marathi. Aplya scanf function jeva lihaycha user kadna input accept karnyasathi, tar aplya eka decimal number la percent 1% D, don decimal number la 2% D lihay lagtat. Theek aahe? The number separate karnyasathi blank madhe. आणि मग ते इन्क्लूड करायला लागतं आपल्याला या डबल कोट्स मध्ये. ऑल राईट, सो स्कॅन एफ विल ऍक्सेप्ट दिस टू डेसिमल नंबर्स. नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज, व्हेन यू ऍक्सेप्ट डेसिमल नंबर फ्रॉम यूजर, यूजर विल एंटर फ्रॉम कीबोर्ड, बट वेअर डू यू स्टोर इट? फॉर ऍडिशन आय हॅव टू स्टोर दिम इन सम व्हेरिएबल्स ना, इन सम वेअर इन मेमरी. सो स्कॅन एफ वॉन्ट्स द ऍड्रेस ऑफ दॅट मेमरी. नो, दिस इज व्हेरी इंटरेस्टिंग डिस्कशन. की स्कॅन एफ वॉन्ट्स वॉट? ऍड्रेस ऑफ दॅट memory. So how do I get that memory? Right, so for example, this is the memory. You can imagine memory as like a theater. It's always easy to imagine, and in theater you always get a seat which has got a unique number in the entire theater. For example, A3 C4 and so on. So here, for example, in this entire memory, these are my row numbers and these are my column numbers. So this is zero, for example 0 to 9, 10, 11, 12, 19. So like this, this is a very location here. Here I want to store my first number and here I want to store second number. So what is the address of this number, this location? It is 23, for example. What is the address of this location? It is, for example, let's say 94. Row is 9, column is 4, so I'm saying 94. Correct. Now interesting point is, you store your data in memory, but do you know its address? Answer is no. Why not? Because the memory that you get in your program, when you get the memory, by the way, you get memory when you run the program. Apan atashi program lihtoy na, correct? Aple program la memory kadhi milnar aahe? Program run kelyavarti. Right now we are writing a program, then we'll compile the program. Compile means translate, and then we'll run the program. Then operating system will give the memory to our program. Correct? So right now while writing a program, I don't know the address na. Mala maiti ka address atta ka ayato? Nahi maiti. Okay nahi? And second thing, even if I know the address, will it always be same? See, imagine, suppose you are planning for some movie. Right now, considering corona cases, we are not visiting theaters, but suppose if you imagine the old days or in future, you want to go to movie in some theater. So right now, if you plan, do you know the seat number? Right now, you don't know. Even if you are regular visiting that theater, for every time, do you get, even if the, let's say, show is same, same movie, will you get same chair, same seat? No. So there are two problems. One, programmer doesn't know memory address while writing the program. Second, that address is not going to be same every time. It's going to change. So what programmers do? They use this memory location, and instead of address, they assign names. By the way, these memory locations where you're going to store data are called as variables. आय रिपीट इन मराठी, आपण डेटा स्टोअर करण्यासाठी जे काय मेमरी लोकेशन वापरतो ते मेमरीमध्ये आपण डेटा ठेवतो, त्याला आपण काय म्हणतो? व्हेरिएबल. सो दीज व्हेरिएबल्स वी हॅव नेम्स, आपण त्यांना चक्क नावं ठेवतो. फॉर एक्झाम्पल हिअर आय एम स्टोरिंग द फर्स्ट नंबर, सो आय एम रेफरिंग टू दिस व्हेरिएबल एज एन ओ वन, अँड हिअर आय एम किपिंग सेकंड नंबर, सो आय एम रेफरिंग टू दिस लोकेशन एन ओ टू, राईट? सो आय एम गोइंग टू यूज व्हेरिएबल नेम्स. नाउ कॅन आय हॅव एनी नेम? आन्सर इज नो. इन यस्टरडे सेशन वी हॅव लर्न्ड की व्हेरिएबल नेम्स फॉलो आयडेंटिफायर रूल्स. वॉट आर दोज रूल्स? यू कॅनॉट स्टार्ट विथ डिजिट, नो स्पेशल कॅरेक्टर्स, नो ब्लँक्स, राईट? सो ऑल दोज रूल्स आर ऍप्लिकेबल फॉर दिस व्हेरिएबल नेम. नाउ व्हेरिएबल नेम आय एम गोइंग टू डिसाइड ॲज अ प्रोग्रॅमर, इट्स अ युजर डिफाइंड वर्ड, सो आय हॅव टू इन्फॉर्म कंपायलर ना, राईट? तो कंपायलरला सांगायला लागतं आपल्याला की आपल्या व्हेरिएबलचे नावं काय आहेत, अँड देन टू अलोकेट मेमरी ऑर टू रिझर्व द मेमरी, कंपायलर वॉन्ट्स टू नो वॉट आर यू गोइंग टू स्टोअर इन दॅट व्हेरिएबल, राईट? वॉट टाईप ऑफ डेटा? सो इन सी मार्केट देर आर फोर टाईप्स ऑफ डेटा: कॅरेक्टर, इंटीजर मीन्स नॉन फ्रॅक्शनल नंबर, देन फ्लोट फ्रॅक्शनल नंबर, अँड मोर ॲक्युरेट फ्रॅक्शनल नंबर इज कॉल्ड डबल हियर, हुज कॅपॅसिटी इज डबल. सो हियर आय वॉन्ट टू स्टोअर नॉन फ्रॅक्शनल नंबर, सो आय हॅव टू टेक इंटीजर, सो अकॉर्डिंगली कंपायलर विल रिझर्व द मेमरी फॉर इट. दिस इज वॉट आय एम टॉकिंग अबाउट डेटा टाईप्स. दोज आर न्यू टू सी इन युअर नोटबुक, राईट डाऊन दिस फोर डेटा टाईप्स, ऑर क्विकली इफ यू वॉन्ट टेक अ स्क्रीनशॉट. कॅरेक्टर रिक्वायर्स 1 byte स्टोरेज, इंटीजर रिक्वायर 2 byte स्टोरेज, फ्रॅक्शनल नंबर म्हणजे फ्लोट रिक्वायर्स 4 byte स्टोरेज, अँड देन डबल ऑफ फ्लोट, 4 into 2 is डबल ऑफ 4 is 8, सो डबल हॅज 8 byte स्टोरेज. सो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू गो फॉर फ्रॅक्शनल नंबर, गो फॉर फ्लोट. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू गो फॉर नॉन फ्रॅक्शनल नंबर, गो फॉर इंटीजर. अँड इफ यू वॉन्ट टू स्टोअर अ कॅरेक्टर, गो फॉर कॅर. दीज 3 आर सफिशियंट फॉर युअर एंटायर BCS, BCA, ग्रॅज्युएशन लाईफ. When you will write some scientific applications, some which will really require accuracy in detail, then only you will require double. Otherwise, it is not required in the academic life. ठीक आहे? ते चार प्रकारचे आपल्याला सी मध्ये डेटा टाइप्स आहेत. मग यातनं कंपनीला काय कळतं की तुमच्या व्हेरिएबलला किती मेमरी हवी आहे, तेवढी मेमरी तुमच्याकडे तो रिझर्व करतो. ऑल राईट? सो नाउ व्हॉट इज व्हेरिएबल? व्हेरिएबल इज अ मेमरी लोकेशन. पे अटेन्शन, नीट ऐका. व्हेरिएबल इज अ मेमरी लोकेशन इन विच वी स्टोअर अ डेटा, अँड दॅट डेटा वी आर अलाउड टू व्हेरी. ओके? नाही, व्हेरिएबल. व्हॉट इज अ व्हेरिएबल? व्हेरिएबल विच इज व्हॉट? ऍबिलिटी टू व्हेरी, दॅट्स कॉल्ड व्हेरिएबल. सो व्हेरिएबल बेसिकली वन मेमरी लोकेशन इन विच वी कॅन स्टोअर डेटा अँड यू कॅन चेंज दॅट डेटा, दॅट्स वॉट्स कॉल्ड व्हेरी Able. So how do you declare is like this: data type, for example mala ha integer paije, so int. Variable sa now, so variable name here is no. So that variable, because it's an integer, it will get 2 bytes. This is the address of the variable 1020, which I have taken for example, it's a dummy address. And in this variable the data that I have stored is 5. Neet bagun gya. Variable sa now no ahe je mi dile itha, जे मी ठरवतो प्रोग्रामर. डेटा त्यात 5 स्टोअर केलाय आणि त्याचा ऍड्रेस 1020 आहे. दोज आर लर्निंग दिस फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम, दोज आर न्यू टू सी, प्लीज नोट डाऊन दिस डायग्राम इन योर नोटबुक. आय विल वेट फॉर अ मिनिट. ओनली स्क्रीनशॉट्स आर नॉट इनफ, प्लीज राईट इट डाऊन, मेक युअर ओन नोट्स. डन. नाउ remember, when you use it in printf you have to be really careful. If you say printf and no in double quotes, it is taken as a string message which will simply print this no as it is no. He slash slash kay tela comment mhanla jato just to show that this is a code, this is output. Then when you say printf percent no, so printf percent mhanje kay ki mala itha decimal number print karaycha aahe. I want to print a decimal number, and from where should I take the decimal number? Take this decimal number from this variable. So what is there is no, NO contains data is what? 5. So variable NO will supply that number 5, which will get displayed here as 5. The variable chat mein apan jo 5 store kela na, to percent %d display hoto itho. Now, if you want the address of that variable, there is a provision in C. There is an operator called as AND. The AND operator lavla ki aplyala tya variable cha address milto. See, so when I say print a percent %d AND NO, just now as I told you, AND is going to give you the address of that NO. AND gives the address. So what is the address of this variable? 1020. So this will print 1020. This will supply 1020. Printf will print it as a decimal number. Clear? I repeat, NO in double quotes will print NO. Percent %d NO will print the data from that NO. And percent %d AND NO will print the address of that NO. Is this clear? ज्यांना फारसं कळत नाही तुझा लर्निंग फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम प्लीज रिमेंबर नेवर प्रिंट व्हेरिएबल नेम इन डबल कोट्स व्हेरिएबल्स आर नॉट डबल कोट्स मध्ये प्रिंट करू नका जनरली आपल्याला व्हेरिएबल मधला डेटा हवा असतो ऍड्रेस शक्यतो कधीच लागत नाही सो दिस मिडल कॉम्बिनेशन इज जनरली यूज्ड प्रिंटएफ परसेंट डी इन डबल कोट्स आफ्टर दैट कॉमा कॉमा इज अ सेपरेटर बारीक बारीक गोष्टी नीट लक्षात घ्या कॉमा अँड देन एनओ एज अ व्हेरिएबल नेम तर हे जे मधलं कॉम्बिनेशन जे आहे त्यामध्ये डेटा प्रिंट करायला आपण वापरतो फॉलोड डूज यू वॉन्ट कॅन क्विकली टेक द स्क्रीनशॉट ऑफ दिस फॉर युअर कलेक्शन फॉर युअर फोटो नोट्स मेक सेपरेट फोल्डर इन युअर मोबाईल ऑर व्हॉट एव्हर यू आर लिसनिंग टू द लेक्चर अँड कीप ऑल दिस स्क्रीनशॉट्स इन दॅट फोल्डर ॲज अ नोट्स ऑल राईट नाउ Look at this printf statement. In this printf statement, what I'm saying, backslash n means on new line, answer equal to, so answer will be printed, backslash t means tab, equal to, and it is going to print the number from this NO. So you'll find this backslash n, backslash t are escape characters, answer equal to are ASCII characters, and then percent %d is a format character. So in one example, I wanted to show you three types of characters used in C, escape character, ASCII character and format character. Je pahilyandi shikta tyanne neat laksha dya, tumhala kalla pahijel ki apan je string madhe message lihto, tyamadhe escape character kutle, format character kutle, te kase vaparayche. Format characters are going to work like a fill in the blank. For example, here percent %d means there is a fill in the blank which will be filled with this variable's data. Variable cha aatmadhe je kai data asel, tyatna to data ghyun to print karel itho. झेपतय होप युअर अंडरस्टँडिंग नाव कमिंग बॅक टू अवर प्रोग्राम सो आय हॅव प्रिंटेड हियर एंटर टू नंबर्स नाव आय नीड टू व्हेरिएबल्स टू स्टोअर टू नंबर्स सो हॅव टू डिक्लेअर दोज व्हेरिएबल्स सो हॅव टू इन्फॉर्म कंपायलर सो एम डिक्लेअरिंग युअर आय एन टी इज डेटा टाईप एनओ वन एनओ टू एनओ थ्री लुक ॲट दिस सेपरेटर इज ऑलवेज कॉमा सो एनओ वन कॉमा एनओ टू कॉमा एनओ थ्री सो आय वॉन्ट थ्री व्हेरिएबल्स टू व्हेरिएबल्स टू स्टोअर two numbers received from user and one variable to store my answer addition kela mala je answer store karayche tade me third variable getle no3 non don number user kadna gela mi no1 no2 vaparlay theek hai then to accept number what is required is scanf so I said scanf percent %d percent %d first number is taken from here decimal number stored in no1 second number taken from here stored in no2 two numbers stored here done Now I want to add them. So NO3 equal to NO1 plus NO2. How to add to number? Using plus operator addition. So you say NO1 plus NO2. Ata ithe addition honar hai and the answer is stored in this variable NO3. Look at this equal to. Equal to is an assignment operator in C language. How the value is assigned? Value is always assigned from right to left. Data store kasa hoto right to left. तर इथं एनओ वन प्लस एनओ टू ऍडिशन होईल त्याचा अँसर एनओ थ्री मध्ये स्टोअर होईल नो अँसर इज इन एनओ थ्री सो हाऊ विल यू प्रिंट इट यू विल से प्रिंट एफ अँसर इक्वल टू परसेंट डी आता परसेंटेजची व्हॅल्यू कुठून मिळणार आहे तर बाहेर न सो डबल कोट संपले की डबल कोट संपले की तुम्हाला त्याची व्हॅल्यू डबल कोट संपले की त्याचा कॉमा द्यायचा आहे त्याचा मला एनओ थ्री व्हेरिएबलचं आपण नाव लिहायचं आहे सो द अँसर इज स्टोर्ड इन एनओ थ्री दॅट अँसर विल बी टेकन फ्रॉम एनओ थ्री अँड प्रिंटेड हियर एज अ परसेंट डी Is this clear to everyone? Now, those who could not write the program, for a time being, take a screenshot of this. And then I'll give you some time to write the code, write the program. Don't worry. Atta tumhala hota reference la, ha screenshot ek kadun theva. Done? Okay, you are smart students. You don't require time to copy from the board. Normally, in classes, when the lectures are not online, so offline lectures, people literally copy from the board. It takes time. Now it's easy. Screenshot, crack, photo. Now, before we go ahead, let's talk about how to write this program. Okay, so I'll just escape this. And then we'll go to desktop, let's say, and we'll use Dev C++ or Turbo C, it's up to you. So we'll write the program for addition here. So I'm using a Dev C++ studio, new file, so Control N, void main. This is a basic function you have to write. And here you say first, let's say printf, enter two numbers, right? And don't forget semicolon at the end of printf. Need baka printf sa p small, void sa v small, main sa m small. And then scanf in double quotes, percent d, percent d. Two numbers, for separating two numbers, I've used here blank space in between here, okay? Then comma. Now I want to store data in variables, where and NO1, that's my first variable, second and NO2 is my second variable, semicolon. If you write like this, you'll get error because compiler doesn't know what is NO1, NO2. So you have to go at the start of your function start. Now you cannot write anywhere. At the start of that function, you declare variable names. So data type is integer. First name is NO1, comma, NO2, comma, if you want NO3, NO3 here. And then you write here printf, and then you say percent d answer equal to, or new line if you want, you can say on new line answer equal, I'm writing short, percent d comma. Okay, I have to add it first. I require NO3 equal to NO1 plus NO2. Addition zali karun data code store kela apan NO3 madhe. So print an answer in NO3. Done. Enter on semicolon. So we have printed the answer. Now let's compile this and run. So you go to execute here menu. There is a compile. It's asking you for file name. Make sure the extension is .c, not .cpp. So I'll write here add two numbers. So add two numbers .c. Save. Done. Okay, now let's execute this. See, so it's asking you what went wrong here. Enter two numbers. There is an antivirus, which is whenever I build a exe, it scans for the exe and then allows me to run that program because it thinks that there's some executable code and it might have virus. I need to suppress that program now. So enter two numbers. For example, let's say 4 and 5. Look at the answer. Answer is 9. It's easy, right? Same program I can do using Turbo C also. I can show you same code. So this is anyway saved. So I'll go to Turbo C. This is also another software which is good for learning. It takes you to DOSBox. This can be also used for Turbo C++. And now I'll write new program. So I'll say Alt F. New. I don't want this previous program, so I'll just Alt F3. Okay. So just now I told you void main, same thing I'm going to write again quickly. Well, it's the same code, so I'm not explaining now. I'm just writing, typing fast as possible. You know, 3 you want, so I'll say printf. Enter two numbers. Scanf. %d, %d. See, here I have to type everything on my own because in Deo C++, if you observe, when I type single double quotes, it gives me double quotes. Similarly, when I just write opening bracket, it gives me closing bracket also. And then printf answer equal to %d. You have to write the answer in NO3. But where is NO3? I haven't written the NO3. So I need to do addition first. So NO3 equal to NO1 plus NO2. Done. Okay. So here what you do is you go to compile. Compile this program. It'll ask you for a name. I need to write the name. Save. So I have to use the name. Let's say same. Add two numbers dot C. You say okay. Well, the file is not this type. This is what is file name. Add two numbers is my file name here. This is what you can see. And then I need to run. So I'll say compile and run. Compile. It should say, see here, when I say compile, observe. It says zero warning, zero errors. And if there are errors, first find errors. Errors kada lagtil. If you have errors, you cannot run the program. And if it's running successfully, you can run the program. So now it's asking enter two numbers. I'm saying 3. Or you can write bigger number also. For example, 60. So answer is 63. How to see the output? To watch the output, you have to say Alt F5. Alt and F5. See the output here. Answer is 63. Clear? Now, what we'll do quickly here is we'll terminate this program. I have shown this program in two different ways. I have shown you this using Turbo C, plus I have shown you using Deo C++. Now, we have a lab faculty, Aniruddha, with us. So I'll just transfer the control. Aniruddha, are you there? Okay. So Aniruddha sir is there. So he is going to show you how to install, those are not having a Turbo C or Deo C++, those are using mobile. How to install that coding app on a mobile. And then in that map, once he shows you how to do it, you install app on your mobile. And then write the same program which I showed you just now and try that code. One me that Turbo C dakhavla, screen dakhavla, tu baka screenshot pan kadun thevla reference la chukla tar bagala tumhala. Okay. So Prakash sir.
Yes sir.
Please send the link of that app on the WhatsApp group so that they'll install that app on the mobile. Aniruddha sir, please show them how to install and how to run the program on that mobile, on the app. All right?
Yes sir.
Chalo. Sure. Thank you.
So good evening everyone. I will show you how to install that app on your phone.
So, please pin his video. Please watch Aniruddha's video. Sorry, you can continue.
Yes, sir. Okay, so can everyone see my screen now? It's a mobile screen. Okay, so what you have to do is first go in the Play Store and search for the app called Coding C. It will appear just at the top. You can see this is the Coding C, the offline C compiler. Just look for this app and install it. I already installed it on my phone. So you have to install it on your phone. So once installation is done, it's around a 30 MB application. So it won't take long to get installed. So once you installed it, then open that app. So the interface looks like this. It's a black screen. And there are advantages of this app. Means if you know that typing in phone is a little bit hard, means if you're typing such special characters such as hash or braces, you have to go in here to go very deep, means in the keyboard. So for that, this app will help you. So they got a special bar over here. In this bar, you can see all the necessary things, that is curly braces, then a double quotes, a tab, even the hash character, percent, etc., etc. so that this bar is very helpful in the coding. So let's do that code. So what we need is first hash include stdio.h. So just I'm just typing it fast. Okay, so hash include stdio.h. Sorry for that. Void main, curly braces, and to traverse around this screen, you even got the arrows here. So you can have these arrows to traverse around your screen. Okay. So let's go on the main line, a new line. Open the curly braces, and inside curly braces, what we will do now? Declare those numbers. So int NO1 just a minute. Then NO2 and then NO3. I just switched to portrait mode because there are meeting controls down here and I cannot access it perfectly, that's why. Then semicolon, just NO2 and NO3. Now accept two numbers from user. So printf, it will also show you the prompts like devcpp. So printf function, it already comes up. So printf, but what we will do is that it's a backslash n, enter two numbers. Okay. Ampersand NO1, it's a comma is right here, and again NO2. So that's how you can accept those number. Then let's do the addition. So NO3 equal to NO1 plus, so for plus NO2, add semicolon after that. And then print addition. So printf backslash n addition of two numbers is percent d. Okay. And then print addition, that is NO3. So let's run this code. Now to run this code, you got a button right up here called as run. So when you hit that run button, you will get this prompt, enter two numbers. So let's say enter first number as 5 and second number as 4. You can see here, it just went out quickly. So enter two numbers. So here addition of two numbers is 9. So that's how you can complete it. Now to see the errors, I will do one error so that you will see how errors are shown. So if you see here, it's a pop-up box called as oops. And then there is a file path and a file name, everything here given here. And inside this, if you can see, they have specified the function name. So in function main, again, there is a file name. And after that file name, there is a prompt called as error expected semicolon before printf. So that they are showing that where is the error. They are even showing the line number of the error. And they are also showing which error we have created. So that again, just complete, release that error, and then again run the code. So if you can see, error has gone. And if we given those two numbers, we are getting the output. And to save this file, you got an option, again, a button called menu, and inside that menu button, you got the save option. So in save, they actually just auto created the some name, but we can change that name. So let's say add two numbers dot c, and if you save this file, so it gets saved. And to check that file it's saved or not, go inside your file manager. In file manager, at the what we say home or internal storage, whatever it is, you can see a coding c folder right there. So inside that coding c, you can see that add two numbers dot c file is there. So it gets saved automatically in your phone, and you can open it anyway, anytime you want it to open. So when we go inside that open button, we can check for search for that file, where whatever we want to open. So let's say we open this file, say okay, and if you can see, the file has opened here. Okay, so that's a coding C app for you guys. It's an Android application. I think Prakash sir will share you the link, and start coding. Yeah, thank you. Hello, sir. Okay, Rui. For iOS devices, there is a offline C compiler is there. I will share a link to you guys, because actually I don't have an iOS device. I have shown the Android version, but for that iOS, there are certain apps that you can use. So I will share that link too. Okay. Anyone else have any issues about the app? Kai kala nahi hai ki any other issues? Yes, Abhishek. Vitva Prad the screen share karun dakudo how to save that file. So I'm again sharing my screen. Okay, so jeva apli file complete karun hoil, type karun or anything. So there is a button called as menu. Right hand side top corner la menu nawacha button hai. Tyachyamadhye save nawacha option hai. So inside save, if you click that save button, you will get again a pop-up box, and there is a auto generated name over there. Means that app automatically generates that name, and actually the name manje ase ki first there is a date. If you can see, there is a first year 2020, then month, and then today's date, and also they specify the time there, so that it gets automatically generated. But we don't need to keep that name, so that we can give any name, means whatever you like. For that time sake, I have given the add two numbers. But it can be anything, add.c or add2.c, anything you like. So just save that file, click OK, and it will get saved automatically in your internal storage, phone's internal storage. Means whatever you have selected as a default, it will get stored there. It will create its own file, own folder called as coding C. And inside that coding C folder, you can see we have our C files. And whenever you want to open that file, just browse into that folder and open that file. So if you can see, you can choose and open that file. रूही कीपॅड कीपॅड तिथं ऑटोमॅटिकली येतो, आपल्याला ओपन करायला नाही लागत. इट विल गेट ऑटोमॅटिकली ऑन युअर स्क्रीन सो दॅट यू डोंट नीड टू ओपन दॅट. प्रथमेश, एरर कशा ओळखायचा? आता ऍक्च्युली मी जस्ट तुम्हाला एक एरर करून दाखवली, बट व्हेनेव्हर यू क्रिएट अन एरर इट विल यू विल गेट प्रॉम्प्टेड. मीन्स लाईक डेव सीपीपी यू गेट दॅट एरर बॉक्स, और इन टर्बो सी प्लस प्लस यू सी दॅट देर इज अ प्रॉपर बॉक्स विच विल शो वॉर्निंग्स अँड एरर, अँड इफ देर आर एनी एरर्स इट विल शो इन दॅट डाऊन बॉक्स. सिमिलरली इकडे पण सपोज आपण काही एरर केले तर आपल्याला पॉपअप बॉक्स मध्ये एरर्स दिसतात. फर्स्ट फाईलचं नाव येतं अँड देन आपल्याला एरर पण दिसते तिकडे. येस राजस, आय विल शो यू. Okay, so we are here in the again coding C. Let's say we will remove this semicolon. Okay, we have removed the semicolon and now we will try to run. So what it's showing that there is a pop-up box saying oops, then there is a files location. First they will show that in which function you have created the error, so that in function main, and then again there's a file location, and what they have shown that line number number 8 expected semicolon before NO3. So if you can see see the error, I guess it's very small, but if you can zoom into this, then you can see what they have given is that default.c line number 8 colon 5. Semicolon, we can run the code. There can be other errors too. Means, let's say that we didn't declare a number. So let's say we didn't declare NO3. So that now you will see that it is unexpected. Okay. So if you see here, see line number 8, NO3 undeclared. Okay. First, using this function means in main function we have use a variable called NO3, but we didn't declare it. So that compiler couldn't get from where this NO3 is coming. So that they have given us the error that NO3 is undeclared. Also, there is again second error. Again that's for that NO3, and it's called with a note that each undeclared identifier is reported only once for each function it appears in. Okay. So what it means that if you use NO3 various times in one function, it will show error only one time. Okay. So let's correct our mistake here again. So add NO3 here, and whenever we add the NO3, it will get compiled perfectly. So that's how you can trace your errors in this, or also in Dev CPP as well as Turbo C++. Brahmaya Sarunke, have you tried? It's not running on Turbo CPP. Please check the extension. Means in Dev CPP, the default extension of a file is .cpp. And if you're trying it in CPP, it might give you some errors because Dev C++ it's meant to code in C++ language. So if you want to code in C language, you have to give extension as .c, not .cpp. Okay, so any more problems, guys? Thank you.
Hello.
हाँ सर.
झाला डेमो?
हो सर झाला.
सगळ्यांना म्हणा की एव्हरीबडी व्हॉट यू डू इज नाऊ यू इन्स्टॉल द ऍप. त्यांना दिले प्रकाश सरांनी पाठवले लिंक. प्रकाश सर मुलांना लिंक पाठवलीस ना?
पाठवली.
हा, सगळ्यांनी ऍप इन्स्टॉल केले तुमच्या मोबाईलवरती. येस, दॅट्स अ गुड वे. इफ यू ऑलरेडी इन्स्टॉल द ऍप जस्ट रेज युअर हँड्स. नो, यू हॅव सीन हाऊ टू इन्स्टॉल दॅट एपीके ऑर ऍप ऑन ए मोबाईल. सो दोज हू हॅव्हंट डन इट राईट नाऊ, इट्स ओके. यू कॅन डू इट टू नाईट and then tomorrow before tomorrow's lecture I'll ask you again how many you installed and what are the issues, and tomorrow at the start of the lecture we'll fix all your problems and then we'll start the next session. Okay, don't worry. So let's complete the first learning part today. Now, what is optimization? As I told you, if 100 people know C language or C programming, only 10%, okay, you can go and ask in any final year students. मी बीसीएस वर्गात, बीईच्या वर्गात किंवा बीसीएस वर्गात जाऊन विचारत असतो काय हा प्रश्न आता की किती लोकांना प्रोग्रॅमिंग खरंच येतं, अँड विल फाइंड ओनली 10% कॅन डू प्रोग्रॅमिंग. नाव आउट ऑफ 10% डोज नो प्रोग्रॅमिंग, दिज ओनली 1% हु इज अ बेस्ट प्रोग्रॅमर. नाव आय एम वन ऑफ द दोज बेस्ट प्रोग्रॅमर्स विच हाव हॅज बीन अवॉर्डेड. इफ यू रिमेंबर आय टोल्ड यू इन माय इंट्रोडक्शन सेशन. सो आय हॅव दॅट, आय एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑर शेअर माय अप्रोच of thinking, you know, how to become best programmer. As my goal is to make you programmers, not only programmers, some of you I want to make it as a best programmer. So how, what is that thinking? Barajansa kaya atanusa program kela apan run zala output ala challe gari. That is not sufficient. You should be always in the searching for the best logic. Okay. So how do you optimize the code? Right. What do you mean by optimization? How can I write the best program? So when you say best program, generally we measure it in two terms. See, for example, I have let's say two softwares or two programs. One program gives me the output in 7 seconds. Second program gives me output in 10 seconds. Which one you will go for? Obviously 7 seconds, because it saves your time, it's a faster program. The apla program fast run jhala paijel, ha apla objective paijel. Second, suppose both the programs are giving output in same time, but one program requires 7 MB of memory and second program requires 10 MB of memory. So which one you will go for? Obviously 7 MB, because that saves your space. Correct? So when you write program, your objective should be your program should run faster. It should have less code optimized kela while tar fast run hoil. And second thing, it should occupy or it should use less memory as possible. I repeat in Marathi, आपला प्रोग्राम आपल्याला फास्ट करायचा आहे आणि आपल्या प्रोग्रामला मेमरी कमी लागली पाहिजे. थोडक्यात, आपण जेव्हा ट्रेकला जातो, हाउ वी बिहेव एट द ट्रेकिंग टाइम? डू वी टेक अ सुटकेस, ब्रीफ केस, एव्हरीथिंग अटॅच अँड बॅग्स टू द ट्रेक? नो, वी कॅरी ओनली बेअर नियम थिंग्स, ओनली नेसेसरी थिंग्स. राईट? जे काही आपल्याला भांडी आहे, जे काही आपल्याला युटेन्सिल्स आहेत, आपण त्यातलं स्वयंपाक करत असतो, त्यात काहीतरी करत असतो. So think like trekking. Programming is an adventurous life and writing a program is like a trekking. When you run the program, you get the same feeling as you go on the top of any mountain. When you climb, when you complete that trek successfully, the happiness that you get, the same happiness you will experience when you'll write your program on your own. Tumhi jeva swatacha program lihun run karal and jeva run hoil, teva to anand, ti nasha veglich ahe. Ta theek hai. तर प्रोग्राम ऑप्टिमाइज करायचं म्हणजे काय करायचं, तर मेमरी कमी लागली पाहिजे आणि प्रोग्राम फास्ट झाला पाहिजे. सो आय एम गोइंग टू शो यू इन दिस वन सिंपल प्रोग्राम हाऊ टू डू इट बोथ. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, यू हॅव टू राईट मेन फंक्शन, देर इज नो अल्टरनेटिव्ह. यू से एंटर टू नंबर्स, सो मी एक्सेप्टेड टू नंबर्स फ्रॉम यूजर, स्कॅन एफ परसेंटी परसेंटी अँड एनओ वन अँड एनओ टू. टू नंबर्स एक्सेप्टेड, स्टोर्ड इन एनओ वन अँड एनओ टू. ठीक आहे, स्कॅन एफ लिहिताना अँड लिहित जा, अँड नाही लिहिलं तर एरर येत नाही, पण मग डेटा नीट स्टोअर नाही होणार, तुमचा आन्सर प्रॉपर येणार नाहीये. त्यामुळे तुम्हाला लक्षात ठेवायचंय, यू डोंट फॉरगेट अँड परसेंट फॉर स्कॅन एफ. नाव आपण आता काय करतोय, अर्लियर प्रोग्राम वी आर ऍडिंग एनओ वन अँड एनओ टू, storing that answer in NO3. Yes or no? And then printing it from NO3. So that third variable NO3, that I'm going to minimize. What I'll do is, I'll just take two variables, NO1 and NO2, make variable kami kelo, and directly in printf, I'll add and print the answer. You can do like this, printf answer equal to percent %d, NO1 plus NO2. Manje, NO1 and NO2 je addition kara, that's the answer je, that answer, instead of storing somewhere, directly send it for printing. Look at this carefully. Upon NO1 plus NO2 addition keli, has an answer, upon the printing la patholo. So the printf will fetch the answer and print in decimal format. So this program is optimized. It is better than the earlier program. Why it is better than the earlier program? Because it avoids one variable NO3. Ek apala variable vachlo, apali memory vachli. Ani ti ek extra instruction dili hoti magashi. NO3 equal to NO1 plus NO2. Ti instruction kami zali. Manje apala program effectively magcha program paksha fast run zala. So this is what is optimized program is, where we have saved memory of one variable and it runs faster than the earlier program. Okay. Now, how do you show better output? Now this was about talking about optimization, how to write a better program. Now I'm talking about beautification. Okay. How to write better output. Chhan kasa output pal disla paijal. Decorating the output. So what we can do, we can print like this. Printf need baga. It's a bit complicated to understand for the first timers. Percent %d plus percent %d equal to percent %d. Understand? One percent %d is like a fill in the blank. Pratyek percent %d ya fill in the blank sa kaam karna rahe. Here we are going to print decimal number. This decimal number is going to come from where? NO1. This decimal number is going to take the value from NO2. This decimal number is going to take the value from NO1 plus NO2. The jevde percent %d, tevde tumhala values double quotient antar comma comma dun lechat. So there are 3% is here. So there are three things here. NO1, NO2, NO1 plus NO2, third thing. Here there are 2% is. So we have got two things here. And NO1 and NO2. Scanf la and lagto, printf la and lagat nahi. Lakshat theva, scanf la address lagto, munu and lahay lagto. And is for address. Printf doesn't need address. Printf directly needs the data. Okay. So how it is going to work? For example, suppose if I enter two numbers 5 and 2, is going to print 5 plus 2 equal to 7. As is output in array. All right. Now let's understand the working. See how it works. Sorry. There are three variables, ABC, for example. You can see in the memory, this is what is memory and this is what is output screen. So you print enter first value, you say enter first value. Scan a percent %d and a, you enter number 5, it's stored in A. Then you get message enter second value. Scan a percent %d and B, you enter number 7, it goes in B. Now you say C equal to A plus B. So 5 plus 7 is 12. That is stored in C, 12. Now you print the answer. 5 plus 7 equal to 12. See, this is how you see. Okay. So those are learning for the first time. Note down this format. Or take a screenshot. In your notebook, if you want, copy it down. Write this printf. You print it. Here are the three format character. Percent %d, percent %d, percent %d. This is also optimized code, but this is showing the better output. Screenshot card like a living get lay. Okay. Now, watch again. Those who have missed it, watch again how it works. Program bagun ghya adin it. ABC teen variables ahet, tanchi teen memory dili yanna teen. ABC teen apli teen locations ahet. Printf ni print kelo, enter the first value. Scanf ni accept keli value 5, store keli yamade. Ya printf se print kela message, enter second value. Apan number enter kela 7, to B madhe store zala. Ma C equal to A plus B ni, A plus B addition zali, 5 plus 7 is 12, ti C madhe store zali, 12. Ya printf ne apla output print kelo, purcha 5 plus 7 equal to 12. This is the answer. Ita return 0 vaparle. So it's okay because 0 is integer. That's why you'll find in main was having written data type here integer. Apan return lihit nahi, apan ma void leto. Ta void main le ma return chi garaj naste. All right. Observe again. One last time. All right. Now, what are you going to do now? First, today, this is the homework I'm giving you for today. It's already we have crossed our time. First, install that application on a mobile or TurboC on your computer, laptop, or Dave Studio, whatever you want. If you have any technical problems for installation, call or message Prakash sir. He will help you in installation. He's a non-technical person, but still he'll help you in installations because he normally takes care of all installations. Right? And then once you install that application on your mobile or whatever your laptop, then first try out this basic program, addition of two numbers, successfully run it. After running that program, enjoying that output of that program, then try the program as a homework. What you have to do? You have to accept two numbers from user, display their addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Char vegre program lechhe nahi yet. You are not supposed to write four programs, write only one program. In the same program, that don same number chi, you'll be doing using displaying addition, that's a number chi, subtraction, same number, multiplication, same number, division. How do you add? Using plus operator. How do you subtract? Minus operator. How do you multiply? In maths, normally we use cross. You know, x vapor the match with happened, paper worthy. Here, we use star for multiplication and slash for division. All right. Is the homework question clear to you all? If you miss the question, I'll still give you in WhatsApp. Chalo. So let's stop here. Thank you very much.